Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. I made up this quick little example to show you why you don't need to have a lot of yard tracks. In this scenario, Norfolk Southern had set off 7 cars from my short line. But, as typical, the cars are not in the order that we want. We want them to be in what's known as station order. In other words, from the front of the train to the rear of the train, we want the cars to be placed in chronological order to where they will be delivered. So let's say we have 3 customers. The first would be a factory, which gets our 2 boxcars. Then comes a mill, which receives the 3 bulkhead flat cars. And then last is the drywall plant, which gets 2 center beam cars. So we're going to use our leased engine and we tie onto our cars. And here's what we're going to do. I'm going to show you how to do all this just simply with 2 tracks. We're going to pull east and I'm going to use the terminology we use, and we cut behind the center beams. And we're going to place those cars into a holding track. Okay, we leave those there. Then we go back to our train and pull east to cut off the yellow boxcar. And we keep pulling and we put our 3 bulkhead cars against our center beams. And then we shove those back. All right, so now we're gonna cut behind the brown boxcar. And using that brown boxcar, we're gonna go back and pick up our yellow boxcar. And then we call it doubling back to our cars. And now look. They're all in the correct order. We have the 2 box cars up front, the 3 bulkhead flats, and then our center beams. So I know a lot of people, they want to have, well, they have 3 industries, so they want to have 3 tracks in the yard. And honestly, we just basically use the main line and a holding track to organize our cars, and that's what yards are for. They're just simply for organizing cars. You don't want cars sitting there for days and weeks. That's not what you want a yard for. It's not just for storage, it's for sorting. So think like the prototypes, try to get more done with less track. Now, I gotta show you my new cars. Let's take a closer look at this. I got myself the 3-pack of the Athern 53-foot bulkhead flat cars. I got them in BNSF, and I'm going to show you why in a second. This is how they look individual if you want to get them individual. This is where I work, one of the many places. I see this car constantly, these type of cars. Now, I've seen them with like a smaller bulkhead or a normal size bulkhead. And notice, that's for North Oklahoma. Like, we see cars, even though I'm in Western Pennsylvania, we see cars from all over. So seeing a lot of BNSF cars is not uncommon. I just want to show you like the size difference. Now, their bulkhead is a little bit different than the ones on that NOKL car, but it's still very accurate. Also, there was body mount couplers, and the more I model and run stuff, I start to notice the difference between body mount and truck mount couplers. I am liking the body mount couplers better. So it also had metal wheels. And now you saw firsthand, I was doing a lot of switching with these cars. Even though they're flat cars, because there's a lot of metal to this, like the metal wheels, and there's a metal underframe, this has pretty good weight. These rolled very smoothly. I was very happy. Now it's hard, even with a good video camera, to really get the small end scale details, like the look at the car markings right there. And now, since I'm modeling modern times, the yellow reflector tape looks really good. And so here's a good view looking down so you can see the wood detail of the deck. And of course, I will weather this along with my other freight cars just whenever I get around to it. I turn it on its side to show you the underside detail, and that is metal. So yes, great weight, great detail. These cars work great. Now, the question is, why would I need them? If you know anything about me, you know I love modeling steel. And I have some steel slabs that I made out of just simple styrene. Get on there. And that's what I see transported a lot in my area. And I didn't have any pictures of it loaded. I'll get that maybe in future videos. But so some of the cars are going to be used for that. But you also see these cars next to tank cars, and I'll explain that. Okay, so look at this. I have a regular flat car with pipe. And pipe and certain items like that can be considered shiftable loads. So if it's next to an engine or next to a tanker car, is that legal? No. The reason why is something that is shiftable could possibly damage the tank car or an engine. There's two examples right there where you cannot have a shiftable load next to a tank car or an engine. And that's why you'd need a bulkhead flat for that. So we got one here because if you're modeling older, you also can't have a shiftable load next to a caboose. Same situation. If you stop, you know, too quickly, that can shift, damage the tank car or damage the caboose. So that's why you need your bulkhead flat cars. That's why these are just an awesome idea that you probably didn't think of. So I am really happy with these cars, and you will be seeing them more on the layout. I'll probably weather some of them also, and I'm going to be doing more videos on how I use these cars. You can also check out a lot of the other products from Athern. They have a live stream every Tuesday, I don't know if you knew about that, but I'm going to post a link to the live stream for Athern on their YouTube channel. And so check that out every Tuesday, and make sure you subscribe to my channel, DJSTRAINS, and you can follow me on Facebook, at Twitter, and Instagram, and all that stuff, because I got more videos cranking out. Yeah, a lot of good stuff coming. I'm so excited. You'll be really, really shocked to see all the cool stuff that's coming along, because I expanded the layout, and it's coming along really great. So thanks for everything. I'm truly appreciative to all you guys, especially those from outside the United States. Man, I love hearing how much people around the world love American railroads as much as I do. All right, thanks, guys. Bye-bye.